Make a date with Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwei at 6 a.m. from Monday to Saturday on Graphic Online via Facebook and YouTube as he expounds on matters of faith.
Graphic Online, truth and accuracy every day.
Hello. This is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwei of Living Streams International, bringing you Matters of Faith with Graphic Online. And this morning, I'd like to capture my thoughts with the words, vials and horns, your choice. Vials and horns, your choice. Now, I've been looking at scripture through some various angles, and I'm looking at some things that are very, very interesting. In 1 Samuel chapter 10, if you remember, when God sent Samuel, when God asked Samuel to anoint Saul, and then the Bible said Samuel took a vial of oil. He took a vial, that's a little box of oil, that is a small box of oil, and then he poured that small box on Saul and then prophesied over him and then told him what kind of service, what kind of life he was going to have, blah, 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 blah. Now then look at it in another portion, in 1 Samuel chapter 16, when God said to Samuel, go to the house of Jesse the Bethlehemite in Bethlehem, Judah, and go and anoint one of his sons to be king. The Bible didn't say, Samuel, take a vial. He said, Samuel, fill thine horn with oil. It was for the same post. It was for the same post. One was a vial, one was a horn. And I'm wondering, and here's the interesting, one was short-lived, one was long-lived. One expired very quickly, but one lasted through generations. The vial, of course, is not equal to the horn in terms of quantum or in terms of quantity, even though it is the same oil. And I realized something. I'm beginning to wonder, what's the difference between the two of them? And why should that difference be? Now, for Saul, it was a vial. And here's the principle. Saul was chasing after donkeys, missing donkeys. So he was preoccupied with something else. He was looking for something. And then all of a sudden, somebody tells him, let's go see a prophet. So he was looking for something. And in the pursuit of what he was looking for, he put God into the picture. So God was not a first priority for Saul. God was not a first priority for Saul. He was already looking for something, and then, let's use God. Let's get to God, and God will show us. So, you know, God was an afterthought. God was a second thought. God was a primary thought. God was not an alpha. God was rather something that had to, an expediency. We need God. We need to use God to get to where we're going. But then David, the difference between Saul and David, David, in the backside of the desert, you know, he was a worshiper. He was saying, as the deer panted for the water brook, so does my soul pant after you. For David, God was first. God was his alpha. God was his everything. In actual fact, God testified, he said, listen, I have found a man after my own heart. And the reason why even David was introduced into the court of Saul was for the very fact that he plays the harp. He was a worshiper. He was somebody who God was first. For him, God was first. Whereas for Saul, God was a stepping stone to something. For David, God was everything. So you can see the difference is quite clear. So he got a vial, but for David, he got horn. You know, sometimes there are people who are looking for the hand of God. And there's a difference between people who are looking for the heart of God. Now for the hand of God, they just want something. So God then becomes a means to an end. God then becomes a means to an end. But for those who are looking for the heart of God, everything, every means must lead to God. For them, God is the object of their pursuit. For Saul, the object of his pursuit was missing donkeys. So solution to a problem, solution to something. But for David, God was his first and his last. And you can see it in such a brilliant way. Immediately he sat on the throne. He said, where is the ark of God? Where is God? I want to make God the centerpiece. You know, God is not a fool. He knows what you're looking for. You're looking for his hand. You may get a vial, but you're looking for his heart, you may get a horn. It's your choice. See you later.